Set the spurs on the mortise gauge 6 millimeter apart and the stock 6 millimeter from the fixed spur and mark the groove. Edge of the drawer rail, use a ruler and pencil and mark points 30 millimeter from the shoulder line previously drawn for the mortise. From that point, use a square and square a line across the edge. Use a mortise gauge and mark the 6 millimeter groove from the mark to the shoulder line. Repeat this process to the other end of the drawer rail. Next, we will mark out the tenons on the drawer runners. Mark shoulder lines on both face and edges 6 mm from one end of a drawer runner. Set the mortise gauge spurs 6 mm apart and the stock 6 mm from the fixed spur. From the shoulder line on an edge, use the mortise gauge and mark from the shoulder line to the end of the piece. Do the same on the other edge and connect the line across the end. Follow the same procedure to the other drawer runner. Marking the curve on the side pieces. Mark points where the ends of the curve will be located, which is 110 mm and 320 mm from the bottom end of the side pieces. Mark the center between those points, which is 105 from either mark. Square a line from that point on the workbench. Set the points on the tramo 211 mm apart, which is the radius of the curves. Place one end of the trammel on one of the mark on the side piece and the other end on the line that was marked on the bench. Scribe the curve. Do the same to the other side piece. We will now proceed to cut the various joints and the curves on the pieces. Clamp a side piece upright in the bench vise. Use a dovetail saw and cut down to the shoulder line. Be careful not to cut past the shoulder lines. Make several more cuts to facilitate chiseling out the waste. Do the same to the other end of the side piece. Use a sharp bevel edge chisel to cut out the waste. Chop out the mortise for the drawer rail using a chisel. A simple way to make the housing is to use an electric router and clamp a batten to the piece to guide the router. However, it can be cut with hand tools. Gauge the correct depth at the back edge, 6 millimeter. Deepen the knife cuts and form a small bevel to use a guide for the tenon saw. Saw down to the correct depth, then chop out the waste with a chisel. For the backing can be easily cut on the table saw. Adjust the blade to 6 millimeter high. Also set the fence 6 millimeter from the blade. Push the side piece against the fence and over the blade. Then adjust the fence and repeat the cut to widen the groove to 6 millimeter. Use a bandsaw to cut out the curves on the side piece. Cut away from the line by a few millimeters. Use a convex spoke shave to smooth out the cut. Clamp the drawer rail to the workbench and use a tenon saw to cut out the tenons. use a chisel to cut out the groove for the runners. The tenon of the groove runners are also cut with a tenon saw. Now cut out all the pieces to construct the carcass.